Hi guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel, and today is another Shopify tutorial, and today we are learning about how to add a custom field only in one product page. So if you don't want that field to visible on all of the pages and you want to display it only on one specific product, you can learn it from this tutorial, and let me show you how it will look like. So I have two products in my shop at the moment, and one have a custom field and one do not have a custom field. So we have defined to display that custom field only in one specific product where we need. So let's take a look. So here's the custom field will look like. It will carry on the value to the checkout page as well, and it will also be displayed on the back end of the Shopify in the product site. And here's the product which does not have a custom field. So let's proceed with the tutorial. And before we do that, do not forget to subscribe my channel, hit the like button, comment on the video below. Let's proceed to the tutorial. Okay, so we'll first go to the back end of our Shopify store. Let's go there. Here we are. And now we will go to our theme section. Click on online store, and here you will see the theme which is activated. I'm currently using debut theme. You can add the code on any of the theme, it should work completely fine. If it doesn't work, leave a comment on the video below so I can help you guys. Okay, now let's edit the code of the theme. I'm gonna click on edit code, and what we need to find here is a product.template liquid file. I have already opened it here. You can find by typing it here, product, and it should show the file product-template.liquid. And in this file, we need to find a form which is responsible to display all of the values in the product. So for example, if I open this product, and as you can see, it's displaying the product name, product price, product variations, and it's pulling all of the details from the product from the Shopify backend. So this is all showing up within the form in the code of product-template.liquid. So let's find it. Here's the code and form, but all you need to do is find and form, and here you can add the custom field code which will be displayed here. So let's try adding a code for the custom field. I have it saved here. So these are the codes to add the custom field. As you can see, it says it will display a field which is required field, and it will also carry forward the value in checkout page. So in some cases you need an optional field. So for example, if user whether want to it's an optional field. If user doesn't fill it will go through, but if it's a required field, user won't be able to go to the checkout until unless he fill up the value of that field. So I'm gonna add the required field code, and don't worry about the code, I'll add the code in the video description so you can easily find it. So I'm back to my product-template-liquid file, and I'm gonna paste the custom field product, custom field code, hit the save, and let's get back to our product and see how it looks. I'm gonna hit refresh, and here we go. We can see our custom field, and now let's test it out. Test name, add to cart. As you can see, our value is being displayed in the cart, and if I go to checkout, it should also display that value there. So checkout, As you can see, our value is being carried forward to the checkout page as well. Okay, now let's get back to the product and try to display this field only in one product, because currently it's displaying on all of the products. So if I open these two products on separate tabs, you will see that this custom field is displaying on both of them. So what if you need that custom field displaying only on one product? So let's, for example, take this product. You want to display this field only on Lion Green shirt. So there's a separate if code which you can add in here to add a condition. So if this product is open, this field should be visible, otherwise it won't be visible and it won't work. So let's add in that code. Okay, so I'll add a liquid code here. If product dot title equals to, now in inverted commas we'll add the product name where we want to display the field. I'm gonna copy this name here, light green shirt, and add it here, and our field code is ending here. So I'm gonna add end if to end our condition which we added here. And if, and now let's hit save. And now let's refresh on the Polo Shirt 2 product, because ideally it should not display the custom field because we have added a if condition, which means the custom field should only display in this product. Now let's hit refresh. And there we go. We can see that Polo Shirt 2 is not showing up that field, and light green shirt is showing the custom field. Hit refresh again to make sure it's working fine. And there we go. We can create multiple fields. So for example, if this product need a your name field and this product need a separate field, we can add in here. So let's try adding a different field in the Polo Shirt 2. Now what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna copy this code. The whole if and the field code, and add just below it. Now I'll rename this field to something else. Make it your, let's make it special requirement. If someone is ordering a shirt where they want to add in a special requirement for that, we can create a field for that. And let's change the ID and name of it. ID, make it special requirement. In case we need to add in some CSS for that field, we can target this ID and add in the CSS code. And we can change the name here to special, special requirement. Okay, now if product light green shirt will display this field, but if someone open up Polo Shirt 2, it should display the special requirement field. Now I'll change the value under the inverted commas and hit save. Okay, let's see what's wrong, which we did. Okay, we mistakenly copied end form as well. So we have two end forms. We need to remove one. We were supposed to copy only the if statement. Now just remove it and save it again. And here we go. Now these two products should display different fields. Light green shirt, hit refresh. It's displaying only your name field. And when I go to Polo Shirt 2 and hit refresh, it's displaying a different custom field which we added. So I hope you guys like the tutorial. I will add the code in the video description so you guys can easily copy it and use it on your Shopify stores. If you need any help with customization of your Shopify store, if you need any help with social media marketing and any other stuff, our agency provide that services as well. So feel free to leave a comment or contact us through our website, websandstore.com. Have a great day.